Think about what are currently the most popular flight controller manufacturers. One would be, of course, Matek. Matek is probably the most popular flight controller manufacturer in INAF world. They are like the first one with majority of their designs. And the second one is most probably SpeedyBee. The SpeedyBee with their series of F405s and F722s is extremely popular because they are cheap. And if you compare the flight controllers from Matek and flight controllers from SpeedyBee with everything else on the market, you will notice that they stand out in a few aspects. Aspect number one, if you see a flight controller from Matek or flight controller from SpeedyBee, you see that this is a flight controller from Matek or the SpeedyBee because of their distinctive colors. Matek with this light blue and white and the SpeedyBee with the black and yellow. You just see this thing, oh yeah, it's SpeedyBee. Oh, it's Matek. So you see, recognizable. This kind of maps nicely, for example, to the Mercedes cars. You see a Mercedes car, even without seeing a logo of the Mercedes, and you see, oh, this is Mercedes. Every next model has the very similar traits, and you do not have to see the logo or the name to know that, okay, it's Mercedes. The same basically happens with both Matek and the SpeedyBee. You see their flight controllers. Oh, this is Matek, this is SpeedyBee. Everybody else is, well, the generic flight controllers. Yes, there were attempts, I think, hackers is making flight controllers in the red. Rush makes some plastic casing. Majority of other flight controllers just make generic flight controllers on the brown or gray PCB, and they are like, they look like any other, but they are different. They are recognizable. And the second trait that I think is very characteristical to both Matek and the SpeedyBee is that their flight controllers are user-friendly. There are no huge differences between the flight controllers. However, both Matek and the SpeedyBee make the process quite easy for everyone because there is usually a good instruction manual, good listing of what goes where, plus the layout of the pads on the hardware makes sense. If, for example, you want to connect GPS and receiver to the pads that are also powered from the USB, it's there. You do not have to look. You have plenty of those connectors, and this is not a problem. If you look at the flight controllers of different manufacturers, very often there is maybe one pad with the plus 5-volt power from the ESC, maybe zero. You really have to search. But those two manufacturers not only have a nice, pretty flight controllers. They also kind of go with this being user-friendly in terms of the features that are for the pilots, so that the pilots do not have to worry too much building their stack, which is a good thing.